Okay, hi. Please excuse the fact that I am sans makeup and kind of sweaty. I just got back from workout not too long ago and it was brutal this morning. And so I figured I would do my questions video while I have some time. Okay, I'm gonna get right into it because I don't want to make it too super long. Thank you for the questions that you guys submitted to me. They are all across the board and all very different, so I will just go ahead and address them. The first question I was asked is on my social media profiles and sometimes on, I don't know, on the blog if I've ever mentioned it, but I have shared some articles and things about introverted people and about being slightly introverted. And somebody asked me how I can share so much on my blog or why I feel so comfortable sharing on my blog about my life when I associate myself with being slightly introverted. I do have introverted tendencies in that I get anxiety about going new places, especially places I've never been. I also can get anxiety about going somewhere by myself, like if there is a supper in the community that I need to go to and my husband or one of my friends can't go with me. It just gives me an anxiety that I'm not going to know anybody and be in a corner by myself or something or sitting by myself, then that's just awkward when I'm put in that situation and I don't like feeling like that. So that is probably a little of my introverted tendencies. Another one is I love going out and I love being social and I love doing things. But I also like to be home, and so I need kind of recovery time from when I'm out and being social. So that's kind of where I feel like I'm slightly introverted. I don't know where I was going with that. So one of the reasons why I feel like I can share so much on my blog is probably because I feel comfortable there and it is a space that I have created, even though there are people that I don't know and beyond reading my blog, it's still my space and it's somewhere my space that I have created and I feel comfortable there regardless of who is reading it, whether it be a friend or somebody I don't know. So it's pretty much when I feel comfortable with somebody, like being a friend with somebody or being close with somebody. I'm an open book. I'll tell you whatever. I'll share whatever. I can share how I feel easily, if I feel comfortable. So if any of you feel like I share a lot with you, then that's a good thing because I feel comfortable with you. The other question I got was they haven't seen any steak recipes on my blog, and they were asking about a marinade for steak. What is my favorite marinade I use? The reason why I haven't shown any steak is because my husband is the prime steak cooker. We eat a lot of steak. My husband loves steak. I would say probably once a week, if not once every week and a half, 2 weeks, we will eat steak. We tend to eat ribeyes, so we typically don't marinate them. I have shared, I think, one steak marinade on the blog, and it's under meat marinades. Typically, my husband puts Lowry's seasoning, salt, garlic powder, and Montreal steak seasoning. I almost forgot the name on our steaks. I don't know if he puts anything else on. I can surely ask him. So maybe we will have to do a grilling barbecue session with my husband. He is the sole griller in our house. I can bake and cook with the best of them, but I don't grill typically. And he's good at it, so I let him do it. The next question that somebody asked me, they weren't sure if I was going to address because they said it's kind of a personal question, but it's not that personal to me and it's a good question. They were asking me when me and my husband or my husband and I were going to have children and if we do want children. And yes, we want kids. If you've followed this blog at any time, you probably remember me saying that I love children. My friends have kids, And I adore those children like they were my nieces and nephews. I love the relationships I have with them, and as they get older and they know who I am and they remember me, it just melts my heart. And I know when we have children, it'll be times a thousand for that. So we have a plan for kids, but who knows? I never thought I would ever, ever, ever be living in North Dakota, let alone married to a farmer. So life sometimes has different plans for you. Our tentative plan is maybe a year to two of having kids. So there could be big changes in the future, or there could not be. It's all in God's hands. So that is the answer to that question, and don't feel bad for asking. There are people in the community, you live in a small town, that ask, so it's not a big deal. And that's the first question people ask you after you get married is, when are you going to have kids? Our reason for not having children right away is just because we wanted to spend some time together, just the two of us, and enjoy things like going on a Harley trip to the Black Hills, or we did our big trip to Southeast Asia and things like that. So we have some good times together, and we have been enjoying our time, just the two of us, and doing things that we can't do when we have children. And everybody tells me that is married and has kids, you will never get that time back. So that is that. Anyways, I hope everybody has a happy Thursday. I enjoyed doing this, and I enjoyed answering your questions. And I will be back tomorrow with Faith Friday. So I hope you guys will come back. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.